Hello, hello, boys and girls. Well, today we are going to do something we haven't done in a little bit, which is to say, we are gonna go and get back into the trucks. All right. Well, so again, the truck series is one of those things where you just. It's always an exercise, that's for sure. And these trucks are so hard to pass with and run a full race with. That's just the way that it is. But the splits, these are kind of funny. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to clear these splits. Well, I can't do it from here. Damn it. So anyway, in practice, the best we ran was a 29.690. That should be good for upper half of this field. I'm fairly confident of that. I think that should put us most likely in the top 5 to 10. Denny Hamlin, there's much talk about whether or not he is the real Denny Hamlin. Who knows? It's possible. He doesn't have anything in his profile, of course. Everybody looks, says he lives in North Carolina. He's from Virginia, Denny Hamlin. But and again, we got Mr. Bad Penny himself, Mr. Dale Ricketts. I swear, I just can't get away from that guy. We race so many different series, and he does exactly what we do every time. So, let's go ahead and get in here and qualify. See what we can do with this thing. So, again, when we're looking at the splits, and actually, well, we're not going to do it. So, normally, when we do our qualifying runs, you guys take a look, and you see that split, and you see that, that number going red or green. And since they've changed the setup so much on this truck from the last time the trucks were here, and not only that, but also it's the same track, but if you run it at night, you can run it so much faster, that these laps will all be in the red no matter what. So we're just going to kind of baby this thing through the corner four, get a good run coming down the top, and just try to open her up as big as we can. You can almost go wide open into this turn right here. Bring it down to the line, hold it down there, drive it up off the corner. That's good. I'm happy with that corner. Now we're going to breathe this corner early and really let it roll up over the top here. I want it to hunt back down to the bottom and then really grab it. And that should be a
One more lap
decent
to go.
time. 29.652. And we're a little slower through that corner right there. Ah, just try to get it too hot and wouldn't stay down. So we are P9 right now. Like I said, I figured that'd probably be about where we were, just running in practice. We were second in practice out of about 30 people, but here's the thing. The people who run the top splits, they're generally not in practice. They know what the hell they're doing. They just need to hop in, do a couple hot laps, and then they're good to go. And for the most part, they don't like to be hanging around with the guys and the other. Let's go ahead and get around a bit. Just the guys. They're kind of snooty. They don't want to race around with all the other plebeians. That, and you get a lot of bozos who run around in the test sign in the test sessions there, and it's just kind of pointless. So, a lot of times you don't see people's best when it comes to there. You'll see some, especially in long running practice times, where you see people just with crazy low times and just nobody can touch them. 29.5 is just, that's filthy. I gotta be honest. Let's cross the finish line here. Make sure our lap counts. Yeah, I've seen a few people run fours. Yeah, that's just filthy fast. It really is. So let's see. Graham, Anthony, Aaron. Two Aarons don't make it right. All right, so we are 11th. What does that mean for us? That means we're starting mid-pack. I mean, that's really what it boils down to, and we've got 30 laps here. Top split, 30 laps. This is going to be relatively tight. 30 laps is going to go by pretty quick here. So hopefully we can just keep our nose clean. We don't want to ruin our race here. Yeah, let's see what people are talking about in the chat here. And Denny Hamlin, 29.650. And of course, we're 29.652. And again, you kind of see like there's a cap here. It's really kind of tight right here at the six, the mid sixes. And then you just get to this whole other tier up here at the top, 502, 504. The next guy's a half tenth off. And then fifth place is a tenth off. And the fixed setups, that's a lot. But again, our buddy Daryl Ricketts hanging out in 18th. But if you look here, us, number 19, we are the bottom I rating in this group. That is awesome. We love that because there is so much I rating to be gained. There's so many points to be gained as well. And we haven't taken point racing all that seriously this season. And the seasons in iRacing are broken up by every 13 weeks. So let's go ahead and knock all these back. Take a look at our competitions. I love that Citgo truck. Aaron, that's awesome. Aaron, I love that Citgo truck. That's awesome.
Thanks, man.
All right, man. We're going green next time by. All right, man. Line up on the inside row. Pit road is closed.
So that's the old Dale Jarrett Citgo car, isn't it? He doesn't know. Of course, got the Trump truck over there. Naturally. I have a video saved of a crazy wreck that happened at Daytona that had one of the Bernie Sanders trucks in it. It was just funny. People were wrecking people on purpose because of that stuff. But that's iRacing. So. And again, who are we waiting for? I think everybody just popped. Nope. Say somebody ain't gridding up. I think it's the guy right behind us. Yeah, P13, there he is. Thanks for joining us, James. Hear that clicking over there. What are they doing? I don't know if you guys can hear that or not, but God, it's annoying as hell. All right, so the line you saw us run in practice, you cannot run that during this race here. You just will burn, you will burn the tires off of this car.
Yeah, good luck, everybody.
This is the C6, not the B6.
You'll burn the,
have hope.
Yeah, we're gonna burn the right rear tires off of this car if we do that every time. And the car gets to be a handful. Now granted, it's only 30 laps, so you can kind of be abusive on this car, and that's it's kind of the bummer about these things.
Yeah, Texas, we died right across the start finish line, so oh, check. Yeah, I have to hope.
Guys, shut up so damn tired, everybody has to do it.
So we've been telling people we've been streaming, but we're gonna keep it to ourselves this time. Unless somebody gets into a fight, and then boom, we're streaming. Ready. Surprise! These fixed races, you don't want people to get away, so you gotta get real tight up on these starts.
Right, the safe car is in.
Nice, stay in your lane, bro.
Green.
Gonna hold it down here, get the draft off this guy in front of us, and try to keep that guy behind us.
Inside.
And that's the way you pass here, you kind of pull underneath people.
Stay high.
We're gonna let him go.
Clear low, clear low. You got one inside. Still there? Hold your line. Say hi.
And again, we just want to save a little bit of tire here. You know, that's what we want to do. We don't want him to get away, but we want to save a little bit of tire.
Still there? Hold your line. Clear low, clear low.
Kind of a bottleneck up here.
Got one inside. Say hi, there's a car on the low side. Still there. Clear low, clear low.
Now granted, they will come back to us a little bit, but we don't want to let people get too far away. Because where you see, we're already five laps in here. We're still getting in a little hot in that corner. We're just not getting it down to the bottom with the way we need to.
Got one inside. Still there? Hold your line. There, hold your line. Still there. Still there.
Make this guy burn up his tires just a little bit.
There's the car on the low side. All clear, all clear.
Again, we're just trying to be smooth on the wheel here, not trying to tug it down, because that is a good way to wear your stuff out. And the way this truck is set up, you can actually watch in the rearview mirror. And I forgot to put more front brake in this car, or take front brake out of this car. You can actually turn the wheel far enough to smoke the right front on this car. That's how much wheel you have to put into this car. All right, so let's try to pour some on here, try to catch back up. We ran a 6.22 before. That was a, yeah, there we go. see people now kind of starting to struggle to hold it down in the middle of the corner. And the cars are going to start to get loose here, coming up off the corners. And it's generally a guarantee you'll have somebody tag the wall. But again, we just want to keep people in front of us here. I know I say that time and time again.
Where the hell are you going, bro?
Had a big old hole right in the middle. Did three wide. Guy came up.
Here we go.
Let the 11 car by. He had the position when the yellow flag came out. Catch the 8.
And again,
car.
You know what's going to happen. I mean, that's the thing, is eventually something's got to give up there. And, you know, I'm glad that we were that far behind.
No, three wide just don't work. If you're expecting everyone to hold their line three wide, you're an idiot.
There it is.
If you think you can't run this track pretty wide, you're an idiot.
Man, we all made it.
It really is now
open.
Alright, so we're going to come in here. We're definitely going to grab four tires.
If you're putting someone on too wide, then you shouldn't be racing. You should be on the interstate, bud.
It's the 8 car.
I can't even handle three wide on the interstate.
Man, but be realistic, guys. Seriously. How many competent racers are there in this damn game that they...
You're obviously not one of them. This track is plenty wide enough for three wide.
Colin, I'm not saying it's not wide enough for three wide. But when you got idiots in here trying to go three wide, I'm not. It's Fatou's fault. I don't know who was below him. But three wide ain't going to work.
If you're scared to be three wide, lift out of it.
Saying. It's not going to work. People race like idiots, man.
There. Line up single file.
Yeah, you don't have to be three wide.
I mean, it's fucking lap 13. Why? I should.
Oh, easy on the LS bomb now, fella. Dang.
Yeah, it doesn't matter if it's lap 1 or lap 92. Three wide's no problem. If you don't have confidence in yourself to be three wide, then back out.
Oh man, I'm confident. I was all the way up against the wall. I know where else to go. Where am I supposed to go?
It's just that people overthink.
So let's take a look at our tire wear while people are being stupid here. Alright, so 97, 96, 97, 98. I mean, we did a good job of conserving tires there. I mean, it's just chewed up stuff. But I think we're going to be, yep, top 10. So, now, we do have a bunch of guys behind us now that have wrecked, alright? So, let's take a look. Yep. Ryan, Mad Guy, 17th. And then we got Denny Hamlin, we got, yeah. So, let's bring up our relative here, because that's what we're most interested in.
Whoa. Oh, God, I'm up front. With all the guys that are way too wide.
Be careful.
Oh, be careful, fella. Be careful.
Ross, if you can't handle it, just lift.
I guess you can know it.
Hey, man, we got two superstars in here. I just realized that. That's awesome.
Get ready.
I don't want to lift. Alan Jones may run me over, even though he's 6 spots ahead of me.
All right, so we need to get a good restart here.
The pace car is in.
Not the best.
Green flag, green flag. You're in the top 10.
But we'll take it.
It ain't clear, fella. Oh, Lord, it must be that careful.
All right, so at this point, we got to go. We got 12 laps. Time to go.
Something hurt on it.
Come on up, Anthony.
Just watching these guys race up here. Oh my god. Damn, man, we just cannot gain ground on these guys right here.
Inside. Stay high. Clear low, clear low.
So you can hear the rear end slip just a little bit right there. See, we're trying like hell to get up there. Say we just lost a little bit of that draft from the lead pack there. Man, these two are racing. I mean, we might be able to catch up to them.
Thanks, Vern.
Thank you.
Alright, man. Two to go.
No problem, Eric.
Thank you.
Got one outside. Stay low. Still there? Hold your line. All clear, all clear. White flag. One more left to go.
He's gonna try it right here. Shut the door there. And again, he'll try it off 3 and 4, but I think he's got somebody looking to his inside too. Couldn't hold it.
Good win, Matthew, man.
Good race in the front,
guys. Well, we'll take it, you know? I mean, to finish ninth in this and just kind of have it fall into our lap, we'll take that.
Checker flag this time by.
Like I said, these trucks are extremely, extremely evenly matched. It's just so hard to pass. Whoa. So get around here. See those two, man. They were locked in an epic battle up there. I mean, they were just side by side for lap after lap up there. But again, wish we could have gotten up there to actually stick our nose into that fight. But again, I mean, we just,
all right, man.
Just did not have enough. Yeah, I mean, it's just the car just felt a little tight, you know, normally then. And when you're out front, it does handle different in clean air. So, but again, we'll watch the last two laps here to see what we can glean from it. And again, we rock the old school Toyota colors here. I like it. The macaroni and cheese number plate. And honestly, I thought he was going to really push it in here, and he didn't. Gave us plenty of room. And again, he just couldn't stick it to the bottom there. You know? Let's go back to the wreck and see what happened there, because that was, when was that? It was lap 18? Yeah, there we are, in the pace laps there. And we know that 15 was involved. Whoa, they got into it even before they got down the front stretch. Watch that again. I mean, they're way up there, and I don't know what the 10's doing here. Oh my god, just a mess. The 10 just does not whoa up here. I mean, he comes right back down the hill, gets turned, you know? Alright, so let's go back. Let's take a look at the 2 for Daniel. And I want to see the chase on this. So he gets a run, and yeah, I mean, yeah, I don't know. I mean, that's, and again, so much junk. mean, he gets a killer run right out of here. And honestly, you just, you can't stick your nose in there. I don't think so. I really don't. But let's watch the, no, not the far chase. I want to see the rear chase. Let's go back. And watch it in slow motion. See, man, like right there, there's barely a hole there. And yeah, I mean, he's just, I mean, he's there. There's no question he's there. But, I mean, I'd say normal wisdom would say you wouldn't stick your nose in there. You know, I mean, either give the guy a bump or fall in line there. Yeah, just to go three wide getting into the corners is even tougher. But it is what it is. You know. But we weaved our way through around the 10 car there. Let's see our chase. You know what? Let's do this. Let's go on board. So let's go gearbox, control F12, and now we're in control of our camera. Let's move it into the car. Let's turn it. Nope. Let's turn it 180 and pop out the roof, roughly. Nope, too many degrees. So many degrees! And let's jump this back. And now we're inside of our roof and jump up. And again, we want this to be 361. We'll adjust the pitch down a little bit. There you go. Voila, roof cam. You can never slow down too early for a wreck, really. And you can see they're still wrecking up here. I mean, I think we jumped from 17th to 9th right there. Oh my god, this camera's off center. It's driving me insane. There we go. Much better. So we'll watch our brace off pit road here. So anyway, Mr. Teal, man, just barely in the box there. All these badges, they just show up on here. I don't know. It's goofy that they say that shit. But anyway, let's go ahead, hop back out here. The melee that is pit road. See, they gain a spot going up pit road. Always winning. Always winning. So. Anyway, let's get back here. Well, I appreciate you guys hanging out. And, definitely, again, follow us on Twitch. If you're watching on Twitch, watch us on YouTube. RogersA51. Post new stuff pretty much every day. All right, until the next time, guys, take care.